printing is a new technology that is slowly transforming many industries. One of these is medicine, where research is being carried out to 3D print implants, stem cells, and even DNA in order to save lives.
3D printing revolutionized every aspect, and we're talking about the medical field. 3D printing saved time, saved more lives, improved the accuracy of the surgery, and improved the efficiency of the surgery as well. In this case, as you can see in this right-hand side of the skull of an elderly patient who was diagnosed lately with a bone tumor growing in the right aspect of the her skull. And what they wanted to do at the time of surgery, they wanted to remove the tumor, and because once they remove the tumor, they remove part of the bone as well. They don't want to send the patient home with a defect, a hole in her skull. So they wanted to remove the tumor and then reconstruct the defect, the hole at the same time. In the old past days, that will take more than 10, 12 hours because you expect it's a complex surgery and it's not easy to be done. But nowadays with 3D printing, you can do every aspect before going to theaters. With 3D models, you can visualize the tumor, remove them, so you can tell exactly how much you need to remove. And at the same time, once you remove them, we design an implant that fits and reconstructs the normal contours of the skull. Nowadays, having a 3D facility in any maxillofacial unit is a must. And the old past days was an accessory, but now is a must.
There is also a lot of work being done to 3D print human tissue, with the long-term aim of being able to 3D print human organs.
3D printing will definitely change the future of medicine. What this technique will allow is using human stem cells as a sort of starting point, then creating human tissues to replace damaged organs or for drug testing, which will enable speeding up drug testing and making them more effective. Personalized medicine will become more easily available. You'd be able to tailor individual medicines to particular individuals or a segment of the population, or create drugs that you would be able then to test on an entire cross-section of the population by getting samples from lots of different people. And then also off-the-shelf parts, you print it in the same way, so you start off with the stem cells, then you're making tissues, and then you're growing them into larger structures that you can then implant to close the organ donor transplant deficit at the moment.
Out of all the uses for 3D printing, analysts are most excited about what it can do for advancing medical developments.
For me personally, it's medical devices the most exciting. And when I'm looking at that broadly, both implants and prostheses, as well as dental and hearing. We've also done research on, and we're about to publish a report on the use of 3D printers in disadvantaged and developing countries, where you can actually take an inexpensive, a 3D printer that costs less than $3,000 and take it to a disadvantaged community, and they can make their own prostheses, not impossible labs. They did it what they call Project Daniel. And Daniel was a young man, 14 years old, who lost his limbs in the Sudan, and so they took a 3D printer. And the exciting part about it was not only that it was life-altering for Daniel, but they left the printer behind. And the locals were printing one prosthetic hand a week in a small village in the Sudan. And when you look at all the unfortunate opportunities around the world for that, that's where it gets me the most excited.